Shalom. Kol halo ala Yahweh ba'ashem Yahushah, which means all praises to Yahweh, which is the true name of the Heavenly Father, who you people in the world only call God. Ba'ashem, in the name of Yahushah, which is the name of the only begotten Son, who you people in the world only call Jesus Christ. Once again, the true names of the Heavenly Father and his only begotten Son is Yahweh ba'ashem Yahushah. Shalom also to the Yuakim, your brothers, that's pushing and spread his word throughout the four corners of earth, who is also uplifting the names Yahweh, Yahweh Shah, Shalom to you, Akim, Shalom also to the Israelite foreigners, the speckled bird, man, woman, and child, whose bloodline traces back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, all forefathers, though you may look like the heathen nations are scattered amongst, which the heathen nations are the nations starting from 2 on down, as you see on this chart. Those are the heathen nations once again. Also, if your bloodline, your lineage goes back to these people that you see right here on this chart through the man. And if his spirit bear witness with his word, the truth, and you can receive it to the speckled bird, man, woman, and child, if this does apply to you, you are Israelites. Though, once again, you do look like the other nations, the heathen nations, you're scattered amongst due to the scattering of these people in this chart. So you once again will have Israelites come looking like the heathen, but they're indeed Israelites because they're under the curses of Deuteronomy 28, the 15th verse on down. Their spirit bear witness with this word that they're the sons and daughters of Yahweh ba'ashem Yahushah. And most importantly, their lineage goes back to these people through the man, no matter what they come looking like. If their father's an Israelite, then that makes them an Israelite as well. To the few Akwaf, as you sisters that do listen, learn, and believe, Shalom to you as well. To the elect of the nation Israel, who have been scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, where this word is going out to, Shalom to you as well. Once again, to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, you combine, consist, and make up the 12 tribes of Israel. You are the Hebrew Israelites, the chosen people of the Most High, Yahweh, and his only begotten Son, who you originally called Jesus Christ. Once again, Yahweh Shah. And I just wanted to do a response, a comment board response. This dude yesterday, he had left a comment on a video I did that Mighty Man Shall Be His Woman, you know? And he, a dude named Nat White, he said, nah, I believe he's an Edomite. If he's not an Edomite, he's either a heathen or a two-third, but I believe he's probably an Edomite for the most part, you know, unless, you know, otherwise. But it says you are part of this country. If this country goes down, you personally will suffer. Well, we suffering now, man. If you, before I take this chart down, if you, anybody that you are part of any of these nations that you see on this chart right now, you are suffering right now, man. Okay? We in hell right now, you know? Let me get the scriptures, because we supposed to suffer for this truth, you know? Real quick. This is Sirach, or Ecclesiastes 2. And, I started one. It says, my son, if thou come to serve the Lord, Yahweh ba'ashem Yahushah, prepare thy soul for temptation. Set thy heart aright and constantly endure, and make not haste in time of trouble. Cleave unto him and depart not away, that thou mayest be increased at thy last end. Whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully, and be patient with thou art changed into a lower state, man. Okay? And that's the thing. Is that not suffering? Let me get another scriptures. We in the lowest state right now as a nation, man. But especially if you're enduring, if you're, you know, dealing with your Yahweh ba'ashem Yahushah, man, you're going to suffer, okay? This is 1 Corinthians 9. And, 11, I'll say it says, if we have sown onto you spiritual things, it is a great thing if we should reap your carnal things. If others be partaker of this power over you, are not we rather? Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we should hinder the gospel of Yahushua, man, Hamashiach. Okay, that's the thing, man. Okay, we endure all things for the elect's sake, so we're gonna suffer regardless, man. Okay, just coming into this truth and knowing what you know, you're going to suffer. Okay? Persecution from this world, man. So, really, I don't care, man. I'm suffering now, man. You Edomites, you heathen on top of us, you know? Coming to work every day, you know? Just the everyday ills of this society, man. It's suffering within itself. So, what is it to suffer anymore? Okay? I ain't suffering nothing, man. Okay? And I'll suffer anything. For, like it says, we suffer all things for the elect's sake. And I will also suffer on behalf of Yahweh Shah, man. Like the scriptures say, man. Okay? That's a part of this, drinking this cup. But to go back, it says you are part of this country. If this country goes down, you personally will suffer, right? Now I'm glad this place is going down, man. Okay? Let me get a scripture real quick. You know? This not even gonna be a long video. You know, just get straight to the point. You know? The scriptures say, for the sufferings that we suffer on this side shall not be compared. Let me get that real quick. See, that's what you people of the world don't understand. You know? That don't deal with Yahweh Shema Shah. That's what you don't understand. You think suffering is always a bad thing. Okay? Let me see. All right. I wonder where that scripture is at. There it is. This is Romans 8. Our scriptures, Romans the 12th chapter, also says what? Make thy body a living sacrifice, man. You know? This is, we sacrifice in this world, you know, doing the having the pleasure of this world, okay, for the truth, man. Okay? This is, I'll start Romans 8 and 16 says, the spirit itself bear witness with our spirit that we are the children of Yahweh by Shema Shah. And if the children, then heirs of Yahweh, joint heirs with Hamashiach, Yahweh Shah Hamashiach, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together, man. Yahweh Shah suffered when he was on the scene, okay? And like the scriptures say, the servant is not greater than his master. So he's going to go through the same thing. But what does it say right here? For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us, man. Because the Lord, okay, through this destruction that's about to take place, he's going to work a mighty work, okay, through his elect, man. Which I'm going to get that. You know, Yahweh Rath is not one of those men, okay? I say that humbly. Because we don't know who is the elect, who is of the elect. We know they're all Israelites, but we don't know who it is, okay? But it's going to be found out real soon, okay? What was I going to get? Amos, the 9th chapter, okay? This is Amos 9, right? And 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord, Yahweh, by Shema Shah, are upon the sinful kingdom. Which that was talking about our nation, the Israelites. But now, this America, which is Babylon the Great, okay, is what? It's the most wicked empire to rule, man, by the heathen, man. Because it's a combination of all the ancient empires. You know, the customs, you know, the different practices is all combined in one. This is why this place is called Babylon, which is the city of confusion, the great. Okay? It's a reason. It says, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth. Right? Because this is what the Lord is getting ready to do. He's getting ready to destroy this kingdom. You know? He's getting ready to uproot this place. Okay? Due to the wickedness that's going on here, man. Okay? It says, saving that I would not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, said the Lord Yahweh Shema Shah. Let me read again. It says, saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, which is what? Israel. Okay, so-called Negro, Latino, Native American, said the Lord. Okay, but this dude talking about we all going to suffer, you know? There's a reason. We suffering now, so we won't have to suffer with the world, man. You know, we won't have to be partaking of the sins of the world, man. The people in the world, man. Because the people in the world, they not going to... I'm talking about, you know, Israelites, speaking of, because you heathen, you can't serve Yahweh Hashem El Shah, okay? They want to, two-thirds, they want to live it up now, and they rather suffer later, man, which that's the worst thing you could do, you know? We choosing to suffer now, so later we'll be all right, man. We could be glorified with Yahweh Shah when he gets back later, okay? But let me read one more time. Saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, said the Lord. Why? Because if you go to Isaiah 1 and 9, what does it say? Except the Lord Yahweh Hashem El Shah of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant, that house of David, the elect, the one-third, right? We should have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah. We know Sodom and Gomorrah was utterly, completely, and utterly destroyed, man. Okay? That's what we would have been like as a nation. Completely destroyed and done away with if it wasn't for the elect. The Lord set the elect up. Okay? That's who it's all about right now. It's about his sheep, his elect. Okay? Those who believe in Yahweh Shah and the gospel, man. Okay? That's who it's about. So he's left a remnant. That's why he's not going to utterly destroy the house of Jacob. Now, two-thirds, on the other hand, they will be destroyed on this side. Okay? But the Lord is going to look out for his elect, man. Okay? Let me see. I had a scripture. Bear with me. The elect, they're going to be straight, man. They ain't got to worry about what this world, the people in the world got to worry about, man. Speaking of the people of our people that's in the world, man. Okay, you heathens, okay, this judgment that's coming for you, starting with you Edomites, man, but two-thirds, since they want to follow you and be like you, they going to get the judgment of the heathen, man, you know? See, the elect, they ain't going to no longer lean upon this system, man, you know? This is Isaiah 10. Right? In 20, it says, and it shall come to pass in that day, what? The time of Jacob's trouble, was where in the beginning of Jacob's trouble, that the remnant of Israel, and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob, shall no more again stay upon him that smote them, but shall stay upon the Lord, Yahweh Hashem El Shah, the Holy One of Israel, in truth. Okay? The remnant, they no longer going to be caught up in Esau's lies and his bullshit, man. They're going to see through all that, man. Okay, when Esau set up these, like he set up these different agents, the elect ain't gonna fall for it. Okay? When he puts on his news, the elect ain't gonna fall for it, man. Okay? The elect is gonna completely detach themselves from this system, man. Now, of course, we do have to work and pay bills, okay? But when it comes to the that RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast, when it comes to society, when it completely collapses, the elect, they're going to be on. They're going to lean upon Yahweh Hashem El Shah. Well, the rest of our people lean upon this broken reed, like it says in Isaiah the 36th chapter in the 6th verse, man. Okay? The elect ain't going to do that, man. The one that smote us, and who's the main one that's smoting us? It's Esau Edom, man. So-called white man. Okay? So we could give a damn if this place fall to pieces, man. Let me keep going. It says, the remnant shall return, even the remnant of Jacob, unto the mighty Yahweh Hashem El Shah. For though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, because there's Israelites everywhere, man. And you and count, try to count every grain in the sea. You can't do it. That's what the Lord is comparing how many Israelites is on the earth, man. The sand of the sea, man. You got Israelites that scattered. You got Israelites that look like the other nations, man. You got Israelites that look like Edomites. You know? So we everywhere, but he's saying though, we be as the sand and sea, that we be as populated, heavily populated, yet a remnant of them shall return. The consumption decrees shall overflow with righteousness, man. So the remnant is no longer going to lean upon Esau and his system, man. Okay? They're going to detach spiritually. And then the Lord is going to have it to where we physically detach. Okay? And really, if you go to Job, the 5th chapter, what does it say? This is Job 5 and 19, or I'll start at 17, it says, "Behold, happy is the man whom Yahweh correcteth, therefore despise not thou the chastening of the Almighty. For he maketh sore and bindeth up. He woundeth, and his hands make whole," man. It's the Heavenly Father that do all these things, not man, okay? Not people yourself, man, okay? It's the Heavenly Father that do all these things. Everything that goes on in your daily life, the Heavenly Father is a part of that, whether you believe that or not, you know? "He shall deliver in 6 troubles. Yeah, in 7 there shall no evil touch thee." Because what's that last plague that's going to hit? It's the second death. It's that the missiles, man. That thermonuclear fire, man. That's what's going to hit last, man. Okay? And the Lord says he's going to deliver his remnant out of that, you know? And famine, when there's no food out here, even the famine of the word, man. The Lord's going to make sure, okay, that remnant, before he brings the destruction, that they're built, they're rooted, man. That they're fully rooted, okay? And the knowledge, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, man. That they have the wisdom and knowledge so they can have stability in these times to come. Okay? So the famine of the word, and when there's a little famine, man, which we're in. Food shortages right now. So when the food really goes, the Lord's even going, let me keep going. Famine, he shall redeem thee from death. And then war from the power of the soul. You got race wars, class wars, okay? World War III. You know, you got all these wars taking place on the streets of America and beyond, okay, we're going to be, you know, the remnant is going to be guarded from that. They're going to be shielded from that, okay? "Thou shall be hid from the scourge of the tongue," when Esau, you see Esau trying to demonize us. Not just Esau, just the people that don't agree with this, that don't agree with Yahweh Shemal Shah, that despise Yahweh Shemal Shah, man. We're going to be hid from that. "Neither shall they be thou be afraid of destruction when it cometh." Okay, let me read it again. "Neither shall thou be afraid of destruction when it cometh." Okay? We ain't going to be afraid because we know why it's coming. Okay? We know why it's happening. Because this place is wicked. Okay? You Edomites are in power. And the Lord's coming to set up the kingdom of heaven. Okay? "At destruction and famine thou shalt laugh. Neither shall thou be afraid of the beasts of the earth," man. "For thou shalt be in league with the stones of the field, and the beasts of the field shall be at peace with thee." Okay, so we ain't gonna be upset like you people are, or miserable, or you want everything to go back to normal. We want this place to be destroyed. Okay, let me get one more scripture, then I'm gonna get the other one. Psalms 91, which this whole chapter is good as well. It says, "This I'm gonna get to Psalms 91:7. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee." What? The destruction, man. So the elect, they're getting ready to witness bodies all over the place, man. People about to be put to death in mass levels, man, which is really the Lord going to use Esau to do it. It's really the Lord's anger, man. Okay? Especially against the Israelites that don't repent, you know, that took this word for a joke, that despised his counsel. He really going to let loose. "Only with thine eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked." Okay, because thou hast made the Lord Yahweh Shemashah, which is my refuge, even the most high thy habitation. "There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling," man. Okay? "For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways," man. So Lord got his remnant. He got the elect, man. He's got the 1/3, man. You sisters that believe as well, he's got you protected. You know? The Lord's not a unjust power, man. He's not about false balance. See, Esau, he'll tell you, he'll give you something. He'll try to take it right back. You know? The Lord ain't, Yahweh Shema Shah ain't the same as you Edomites, man. Okay? He's righteous. You're wicked. Okay? The Lord's righteous in all his ways. He's not like you Edomites. He's come to destroy you Edomites for that. Okay? But the point being is the elect ain't going to be touched. Now, some of them are going to be martyrs, but even if they're martyred, if they die on this side, they're going to be raised right back up first, man. New bodies, laws, statutes, and commandments, and inward parts, and what? Spiritual power, man. Yep, spiritual power. As crazy as it sounds, it's going to happen. Everything else in the scriptures is being fulfilled right now. So what makes you think that's not going to happen? Okay? But We fully okay with this place going down, man. This place needs to go down, okay? This place has done nothing but destroy, you Edomites, but you run America. You've done nothing but destroy the planet Earth, man. You continue to plot and try to destroy our people, okay? And you oppress the Earth, man. You oppress the people on there. So you got to go, okay? This ain't the end-all be-all, man. It's a hereafter, man. Your kingdom is not the end-all be-all. It's going to be something way better than this, you know? What was I going to get? This is Second Ezra. So I'm looking forward to the destruction. I wake up, go sleep every day. Is it going to be destroyed tomorrow? Is this place going to be destroyed tomorrow? Is this place going to collapse tomorrow? You know? This is Second Ezra 4. You know? If you don't want this place to be destroyed, then you're against. Okay, yeah, like I, you're anti-Messiah, man. You're against, okay, the plans of the Heavenly Father, man. Okay? You want wickedness to thrive. This is, damn. Hold on. In order for, you know, better things to come, you know, righteousness to reign supreme, and you know, a world, fresh air, fresh food. The women are actually women, you know. The men actually act like men. This place gotta go. That can't come until this place gotta go, because the scriptures say, "And this with my kingdom, will my servants fight for me?" This ain't the kingdom of Yahweh by Shema Shah, man. This is the kingdom of the wicked, man. You know, Second Ezra. Hold on. Yep. Second Ezra 4 and 20. Yep. This is Second Ezra 4 and 26. It says, "Then answered he me and said, the more thou searchest, the more thou shalt marvel. For the world, what world? Esau's world, man. Because Esau's the end of the world, Jacob's the beginning of it that followeth. For the world hasteth fast to pass away, man. Look at this world, man. Go back 2-3 decades and see what you were able to do and compare that to now. You can hardly do anything now. You got to go everywhere, wear a mask, okay? You got to, you can't go into a business and sit down and eat the GMO food that they sell you, you know? Sports is gone, which is sports, and it was garbage anyway, okay? Sports gone. All types of entertainment is gone. Okay? Cashless society is here now. You know? This world's passing away, man. You know? What's left here to hold on to? Nothing. Especially if you were Israelite. We've had nothing in this place. This place is not our rest, man. We came here to serve out our captivity, our punishment for transgressing against Yahweh by Shema Shah, man. You know? We didn't come here to thrive, have our own business, and just be like Esau, man. And cannot comprehend the things that are promised to the righteous in time to come. Because the scriptures say also, the world, this world is for many people, but the world to come is for few. You know? For this world is full of unrighteousness and infirmities. But as concerning the things whereof thou askest me, I will tell thee. For the evil is sown, but the destruction thereof is not yet come. But it is about to happen. You know? If therefore that which is sown be not turned upside down, wickedness is not put out the earth, right? If the place where the evil is sown pass not away, then it cannot it come that it's sown with good? Okay? So in order for the kingdom of heaven to be set up, this kingdom has to fall, man. That's how it's always worked with the empire. When another nation was coming to power, they couldn't fully come into power until what? The ruler that's in power fell, completely fell, man. You know? So we looking forward to this, man. You know? Let me end it with one more. Bear with me. Seek one to come. Alright, this is it's in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews 13 and 14. For we have no continuous city. Talking about you Israelites, man. Something called Negro, Latino, Native American. We don't have no continuous city here. All you do is wake up, go to work for Esau, get crumbs, you pay your rent, and you broke the neck. You broke after that. Then you just continue that same cycle over and over, man. We have no continuous city here, man. The nations hate us. We're a byword amongst the nations. Okay? This place, we have no continuous city. But we seek one to come. What's that kingdom we seek to come? Our kingdom, man. The kingdom that Yahweh Shah is coming to set up on the planet Earth, man. That's what we are seeking to come. A kingdom of righteousness, man. Where we're ruling over our oppressors now. You know, where the resources is coming to us, man. Not us going to our enemies, okay, for one of our things. We tired of that, man. Let's play it out, you know? Let me get one more scripture. You know? It's in the book of Psalms. Psalms 84. This was the sons of Korah saying this. But what did he say? This is Psalms 84 and 9 says, Behold, our power, our shield, and look upon the face of thine anointed. For a day in thy courts is better than a thousand. So he's saying a day and the kingdom of heaven basically is what? Better than a thousand, man. On this side, and it says, I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my power than to dwell in the tents of wickedness, man. So this is the same mindset we have. We would rather be a doorkeeper in the kingdom of heaven, you know. It's going to be a higher vibration in this kingdom. This kingdom is played out. It's base, man. The basis of men is ruling this kingdom, man. Okay? So he's saying he'll rather be a doorkeeper in the kingdom of heaven than to dwell in the tents of wickedness, man. Because this place, you have to deal with homosexuals. You have to deal with a woman out of order. You have to deal with weed smoking, tattoo covered, you know, dread wearing niggas, man. You know? This place is played out. So we seeking a new, okay, earth, man. We seeking a new kingdom, okay? This place is finished. So that's it. Call Halal Allah Yahweh by Hashem El Shah. Yahweh Ratazaz is edifying. Baba Kasha, Baba Bo, Baba Bo, Abaha Ayapia, Abaha Ayapia. Shalom to the elect and to the few Aqua Israelite sisters that do believe, listen, and learn, and repent. No, Shalom.